Number two, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم allowed the believer to kill to those women who dress in this fashion. Number three, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, لا يدخلن الجنة ولا يجدن ريحها. وإن ريحها لا يوجد من مسيرة كذا وكذا. جنة is so beautiful. And جنة that from a far away you can smell جنة. But those women who are dressed but they are naked, they're going to be prevented from entering Jannah. They are not permitted to smell the pregnancy of Jannah. So we call in our sisters, our daughters, our wives, the Muslims, those who are here today, and those who may hear the tape at any time. We advising you for the sake of Allah. But if you are coming to our own center, after we advising you, it's going to be a different action. Because we could not allow the munkar. Otherwise, we be cursed. Because we have authority in our property. You like it or not? Allah has given us a mask. And we are the guardian of this mask. And men are in the charge of their wives. And men are in the charge of their families. And the imam in the charge of his mask. And everybody have to carry his responsibility to the best of his ability. We are not going to say, she's my wife and my daughter, I talk to her. It is your obligation as a husband, as a father, to change it with your hand. And it is my obligation also as an imam in the mosque that I will remind, correct, and teach. And if it takes for me to stop it with my hand, this is my right. This is my right. But first, we let the people know that this is wrong. And we telling you that you need to save yourself from hellfire. With this hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, كاسيات عاريات. So the purpose of your dress is not to cover your skin color. The purpose of your hijab to make you invisible, to make you hide, to make nothing can be seen from you. And Sheikh Al-Albani rahmatullahi alayhi, when he indicates in this condition of dress, he said, الشرط الرابع, the fourth condition, أن يكون فضفاضا غير ضيق فيصف شيئا من جسمها. That her dress, whatever she's wearing, if it's abaya, if it's milaha, if it's jilbab, whatever she wearing, it have to be loose. Not tight, not to prescribe or describe or shape any part of her body. Now listen to this hadith, which reported by Usama radiallahu anhu, is support to the condition that the Shaykh had brought for the condition of the Muslim dress for a woman. This hadith, قال أسامة بن زيد رضي الله عنه كساني رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قبطية كثيفة مما أهداها له دهي الكلبي فكسوتها امرأتي فقال ما لك لم تلبس القبطية قلت كسوتها امرأتي فقال مرها فلتجعل تحتها غلالة فإني أخاف أن تصف حجم عظامها. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had gave Usama a gift from this cloth that been brought from a different country. First, the hadith is the collection of Imam Ahmad and al-Bayhaqi and Abu Dawood. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the hadith which is reported by Usama ibn Zayd, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave him a special dress called qibtiyya. Okay? So he went and gave it to his wife. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he saw Usama, he asked him, why you didn't wear this dress or this soap or this qibtiyya that I give you? He said, oh Prophet of Allah, I give it to my wife to wear it. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to him, murha, order her to put a ghilala, to put another dress under it, because I'm scared that it may show the shape and the size of her bones. It's clear. This kind of material was so soft. So when a woman drop it in her body, it will be folded according her size. Now we want to see, my brothers and sisters, the problem that we see with some sisters coming to the mosque, wearing a skirt that split from the front, or from the back, or from the side, or wearing a pants, or those who think that they are in the proper hijab, wearing a scarf, and barely cover the end of her hair. Now what happened to her bosom? What happened to her chest? What happened to her back? You can see everything. This is haram, this is corruption, and this it shouldn't be in a place for worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Muslims coming to obey Allah, to worship Allah, not to be through temptation even in the mosque. This is haram, this is wrong. Those who did not understand, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلْيَضْرِبْنَ بِخُمُرِهِنْ عَلَى جُيُوبِهِنْ. He didn't say round the neck. Allah said, let them strike with their veil over their bosom. So this hijab, this is tarha, this is khimar, whatever what you call it, is not for purpose of covering your neck. And this kind of fashion, from where it came, that we see it in our community, or in our mosque for the last year, is so bad that the sister taking the hijab or the scarf and barely going around her neck and her head. Now you can see the size of the shoulder. Now you can see her chest sticking in front of her. Now you can see her back. You can see everything in details. This is reality. And this is haram. I'm not going to stand here hinting towards something and nobody know what I'm talking about. We want to come direct to the point that this is wrong. Allah said, let them strike with their veil, the headpiece, over their bosom. This is the place, Fathat al-Jayb. وَلْيَضْرِبْنَ بِخُمُرِهِنَّ عَلَى جِيُوبِهِنْ. This is the Jayb. This is the opening of your dress. This is called Jayb. So Allah said, let this khimar go over the opening of your dress to cover your chest. So now when a sister coming with a scarf, barely covering the head of her neck. This is not right. This is temptation. And any girl or any woman that come in here for purpose of temptation, let her stay home. Let her stay home, otherwise you get the curse of Allah and you deserve the curse of the believers. And it is permissible for them to curse you. Not yet go into the face of a sister and say, may Allah curse you. You can see her from a distance and you can say, may Allah curse you. You are right. Nobody can say you are wrong about this. She deserves the curse of Allah if she does this. Women coming with the pants, coming with a, what you call, a jiba or a skirt, up to half of their legs, and after this wearing a stocking. And this is also kasiyat in ariyat. She is dressed covering her leg, but still showing the size of her calf, her leg, or showing the color. This is wrong, totally wrong. My dear respected brothers, you have to understand this. You could not be shy from your wife, you could not be shy from your daughter, you could not be shy from al-haq. Our responsibility is to forbid the evil. If we could not even forbid evil in our mosque, forbid the evil in our own house, what kind of manhood is this? And my dear respected sisters in Islam, this is haram, this is totally haram, this is corruption in the Muslim community, and this shouldn't be done. So if you're wearing a pants, or you're wearing a scarf, and you're still wearing a jilbab, this is not jilbab. Because you're wearing a jilbab, but your shoulder, the